Now, when Facebook founder and chief executive officer Mark Zuckerberg appeared before the American lawmakers earlier this week, the world was watching very closely, and the most concerned lot were users of the social media platform, people who used Facebook. But there was something that got even those who are not on Facebook, who've not been using Facebook, worried. Our next report explains.
It's a well-known secret that is now out in the open. On the second day of Zuckerberg's testimony before the American lawmakers, the founder of Facebook made a shocking admission.
Facebook has detailed profiles on people who have never signed up for Facebook, yes or no?
Congressman, in general, we collect data of people who have not signed up for Facebook for security purposes to prevent the kind of scraping that you were just referring to.
Yes, you heard it right. If you thought that not being on Facebook safeguards your data, you were just proven wrong. The world's biggest social media platform is snooping on you, even if you do not have a profile. How so, you may ask? Well, anyone who joins Facebook is given the option of sharing contacts on his phone and email ID. Once they agree to it, the information on their device is synced with the account, which includes data of users who are not on Facebook too. This information is stored in data black box on the servers of the company at its headquarters. It creates what is called a shadow profile of non-users too. And if somehow you devise a way out of this complicated snare, there's more. Remember the like buttons you see on web pages you visit. The embedded feature helps Facebook track a user. Even if you're not on the social media site, your online footprints are recorded by Facebook in huge troves of data, which can be used to target you if you ever feel like joining Facebook. While a non-user can do precious little to prevent Facebook from creating his shadow profile, its users can meanwhile protect their data by choosing not to sync their contacts from the phone or email ID, using incognito mode to browse the net, and not logging onto apps or websites using Facebook. What started as a prank website in the dorms of Harvard University seems to be taking up dangerous proportions, one that demands immediate and stern intervention before the situation spirals completely out of hand. Bureau Report, WION.